So first and foremost, we want to give praises to Yahweh, Bashem Yahushai, double honors to the Apostle Rugal, Edmund Stone. It's a sanitation to all the Akim, the Houdini, four corners of the earth, who preaching the gospel in sincerity and truth. Shalom. This evening, I want to speak about, on the topic about fear, you know, that we're supposed to fear the Heavenly Father, you know. Reference His word, respect His word, you know, be obedient unto His commandment. That word, we must be, must have the fear, you know, just to feed the elect. You know, having the fear is very important. You know? Yeah. You know, tutorials, you know? Yeah, they don't have the fear, you know, so start off with this Proverbs chapter 14. I mean, start with verse 26. He said, "In the fear of the Lord Yahweh is strong confidence, and his children shall have a place of refuge." You know what I mean? A place, a hiding place from destruction, you know. Like he said, in the fear of the Lord Yahweh is strong confidence, you know. We believe in him, you know. We believe in the time, you know. By having the fear, we do exactly we say, you know. We believe and hope wholeheartedly that he can protect us, you know. So having the fear is very important, you know what I mean? Yeah, that's the fear there is very important. Having the faith for the Heavenly Father is wisdom, you know, because like I say, only the elect, only the most high elect don't fear him. Two-thirds of Israel, you know, they don't fear the Heavenly Father. They will ask a thing like, why we should fear him. But that day can come, you're going to know Jacob trouble, you're going to know why. You know? Because he can make known to you why you should fear him. Sometimes he can be mocking at you and laughing at you, you know? Because you despise what you despise his word, you know? So fear, fear of Nephi is very important. You know? He said, in the fear of the Lord, Yahweh is strong confidence, and his children shall have a place of refuge. Right? Look at this one in Psalms. Psalms 103, verse 17. Psalms 103 verse 17, he said, but the mercy of the Lord Yahweh is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him. So the mercy from everlasting to everlasting gonna be on them, which is the elect, the most high elect that fear him. So the mercy gonna be on them who that fear him. They're gonna be the mark tav, gonna be on the forehead, exemption from destruction. There's gonna be the place of refuge, you know. The most high gonna be the hiding place, you know. So he said, but the mercy of the Lord Yahweh is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness upon the children's children. You know what I mean? So the fear is very important to have to the Heavenly Father, you know what I mean? Walking his commandments, you know, his statutes and his judgment to your best ability, you know what I mean? And seek him, you know what I mean? Seek him for us, put him for us, you know? The fear is very important, all right? Let me go back to Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 26. In the fear of the Lord Yahweh is strong confidence, and his children shall have a place of refuge. Verse 27. He said, the fear of the Lord Yahweh is a fountain of life. Yeah, it's a fountain of life, you know what I mean? To depart from the snare of death. And like I say, they that fear me, you know what I mean? Most I can show mercy unto them, you know? Yeah, so the fear is very important. The fear of the Lord Yahweh is a fountain of life to depart from the snare of death. The death is destruction that come in, you know. The race bar, the famine, you know, the martial law, the RFID microchip, you know, the nuclear war, you know what I mean? So it's, you know what I mean? So the fear, then the fear can be a ticket out of here too, you know what I mean? And also humbling yourself in the sight of the Heavenly Father too, you know, and believing on Yahweh Shai, you know? So the fear is very important too. You know, and like I say, two-thirds of Israel despise the word, you know, they don't believe, you know. They get caught up in this wicked society, you know. This is Proverbs chapter 30, verse 13. Whosoever despise the word shall be destroyed. You know, so then who ain't got faith in the Most High gonna be destroyed, you know. Yeah. But he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. You know what I mean? So the fear is very important to have for the Heavenly Father. You know what I mean? The fear of God, the fear is respect, you know, reverence, you know what I mean? Yeah, he said, whosoever despise the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandments shall be rewarded. Yeah, you can be rewarded with what? Mercy. You know what I mean? You can be rewarded with mercy because he show respect unto the Heavenly Father, you know what I mean? The Heavenly Father said, don't mark a beard, you know, don't eat pork. Don't celebrate these pagan holidays, you know what I mean? Just don't do these things. So you mean you're showing respect unto the Heavenly Father, you're doing what he say, you know what I mean? Father gonna love you for that. You know, show you mercy. You can remember that the good things you do, and they're gonna be a ticket out of here. You know what I mean? They're gonna be mercy. You know? Yeah, this one in the Apocrypha. This is Ecclesiasticus chapter 2, verse 15. He said, they that fear the Lord Yahweh will not disobey his word. So the elect not gonna disobey the word. You know what I mean? They're gonna be obedient unto the Heavenly Father word, you know. He said, and they that love him will keep his way. And you know, and what is love? Love is that we walk after the commandment, you know. This is the way we show the Most High that we love him, by doing his commandments, you know what I mean? Doing what he say, what he command you to do. And they're showing love unto the Most High. It's not lip service, you know. It's indeed. Your deed is the deed. You know what I mean? Doing the works of the Heavenly Father, you know what I mean? Being obedient to what we say, you know. Verse 15 said, they that fear the Lord, Yahweh, will not disobey his word. And they that love him will keep his way, you know. Verse 16, they that fear the Lord, Yahweh, will seek that which is well pleasing unto him, and they that love him shall be filled with the law. And that's how you show the Most High you love him. Into 2 John 7:6, this is love, that we walk after his commandment. You know what I mean? That's how we show the Heavenly Father that we love him, when we do the things that is pleasing unto him, that he commanded us to do from since the beginning, you know. Verse 17, they that fear the Lord Yahweh will prepare their hearts and humble their soul in his sight. You know what I mean? So you can prepare your mind, and the sacrifice in the Most High as well, of a contrary and broken spirit, of a contrary heart. You know what I mean? Putting it in Psalm 51 and verse 17. You know what I mean? Yeah, so the Most High also love a humble person. You gotta be humble as a child, right? He said, they that fear the Lord Yahweh will prepare their hearts and humble their soul in his sight. So there's another way you gotta be too. You gotta be humble in this thing of ours. You gotta be real humble, you know what I mean? You gotta humble yourself. You can't be proud, you know. That's the only way you're gonna the Most High gonna receive it too, is by being humble, you know what I mean? Yeah. Alright, Proverbs, Proverbs 15:33. This is Proverbs chapter 15, verse 33. He said, a fear of the Lord is the instruction of wisdom. Is the instruction of wisdom. So to fear the Most High is wisdom, because the Most High could dash in many pieces, you know, just like we clay dust as grass inside to the Most High, you know. So the fear of the Lord Yahweh is the instruction of wisdom, and before honor is humility, the mean a humble spirit, mean humble, meekness, loneliness, you know, mean humble. Humble before the Heavenly Father. You know what I mean? So the fear is very important. Humbling yourself is very important. And also believing on Yahweh Shai. You know what I mean? So, yeah, man. This is like I say, two-thirds of Israel don't give a fuck about the Heavenly Father, you know? And they already marked to death. You know, two-thirds of Israel going to be destroyed. But it's only the elect. You know, going to have the fear and humble yourself before Him. You know what I mean? Yeah, and show the Most High how much they love Him by what? Walking in His commandments, keeping it to the best ability, you know, and also believing on Yahweh Shai, you know. God is important too. Believing is very important. Because look at our forefather Abraham. He believed the Most High Yahweh, and it was an important thing for our righteousness, you know. Yeah. Proverbs 1 and 7. This is Proverbs chapter 1 verse 7. He said, the fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of knowledge. The beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. So to fear the Most High is the beginning of knowledge. You can open up your mind, you know, feed it with knowledge, you know what I mean? Bring it to life from a dead state into life. So you gotta fear. You know what I mean? Like I said, only the elect go fear Him. You know, so the fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. The fools despise this word, you know, which is what is Yahweh Shai. They despise it, you know. They don't want to hear this. They don't want to hear this song. They want to hear the song of fool. They want an enticing word, you know. And these things, they despise it, you know. So Most High gonna destroy them, you know. Verse 15. This is Proverbs chapter 15:9. He said, the way of the wicked is an abomination unto the Lord Yahweh. The way of the wicked is an abomination unto the Lord Yahweh. But He loveth him that follow after righteousness. So the way of the two-third, the so-called white man, the other nation, heathen nations, they are abomination unto the Most High. You understand? So they don't fear the Heavenly Father. The two-thirds of Israel don't fear the Heavenly Father. The so-called white man don't fear the Heavenly Father. These are the heathen nations. They don't fear the Heavenly Father. So the way of the wicked is an abomination unto the Lord Yahweh. He said, but He loveth him that follow after righteousness. So we, through the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, you know, we through the scriptures, we know that the Most High hate all abomination. You know what I mean? All, not some. All abomination. You know? So, you can pull out Kekis. You can pull out in Sirach 15 and right? Kind of moving less slow, you know? Alright. Jack 15:13. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 15, verse 13. He said, the Lord Yahweh hated all abomination, and they that fear the Most High love it not. So the elect, not gonna love abomination, you know what I mean? God, well, we fear the Heavenly Father. So the Lord Yahweh hated all abomination, and they that fear the power of Yahweh love it not. So we're not gonna love it, we're not gonna love the abomination. We despise that, you know, because well, we have the fear for the Heavenly Father, you know. Fear for the Heavenly Father. So back to Proverbs, they say, slow as a day, boy. Yeah. This is Proverbs chapter 15, verse 9. He said, the way of the wicked, which is the two-third of Israel, the so-called white man, the other heathen nation, is an abomination unto the Lord Yahweh. But he loved him that follow after righteousness. So he loved the elect, God, the elect and who, elect and follow after righteousness. So you see what's righteousness? Right, only the elect gonna follow after righteousness, you know. And the 1/3 men, women, and children, you know, who gonna be delivered, they gonna follow after righteousness, you know what I mean. Yeah, this is Psalms 119, verse 172. He said, my tongue shall speak of thy word, for all thy commandments are righteousness. You know what I mean? So they say, only elect gonna follow after righteousness. He said, my tongue shall speak of thy word, for all thy commandments are righteousness. You know? So only elect gonna follow after the righteousness. You know what I mean? Proverbs 16. Proverbs 16. He said, this is Proverbs chapter 16 verse 6. He said, by mercy and truth iniquity is purged. So by mercy and truth iniquity is purged, and by the fear of the Lord Yahweh men depart from evil. So the fear is very important. We're not gonna go and worship Christmas and this demon that they were coming up here. We not gonna worship that, but what we got, what we fear the Heavenly Father. We know the Father would, you know, the Father would destroy we for that, for knowing better and going and taking part in them thing, you know. And as one of the brothers saying in a recent video that one of the brothers sent, he said, don't be over too righteous, neither too or over too wise. Nothing wrong, you can eat the food, you know, but deep down in your heart, you know that you're not for that, you know. But like I say, you know, we're gonna depart from these things, because we know this thing of no profit, this thing is vain, you know what I mean, it's vain customs. We're not gonna take part in these things, you know what I mean. So, but mercy and truth, he says, Salaki, by mercy and truth iniquity is purged, and by the fear of the Lord Yahweh men depart from evil. So we depart from evil, you know. Not gonna eat pork, you know. We not gonna be lying to one another, you know. I mean, we not gonna look into steal and cause discord, I mean, or brethren and all this thing. You know, we not gonna be doing it because this thing is evil, you know what I mean? 4:7. Alright, he say, when a man's way please the Lord Yahweh, he make it even his enemy to be at peace with him. So when we got a lot of enemy out there. Two-third of Israel is our enemy. So-called white man is our enemy. The heathen nation is our enemy. They want to destroy we. They want to see we destroy our world. You know, the Most High wrote in the kingdom of men. You know what I mean? When a man's ways please the Lord Yahweh, he make it even his enemy to be at peace with him. You know what I mean? So, the fear is very important to have. You know what I mean? Very, very important to have. Go to the Apocrypha. And the fear is very important to have. It says, the fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of his love. To fear the Most High is the beginning of His love. To fear the Most High is the beginning of wisdom. You know what I mean? And faith is the beginning of cleaving unto Him. You know? Read that again. He said, the fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of His love. And faith is the beginning of cleaving unto Him. You know what I mean? Yeah, this so fear is very important. You know what I mean? How faith come? Faith come by hearing the word. I think that's Romans 10 and 7. Get us quick. Yeah, faith come by hearing the word. You know, so it's very important. You know what I mean? It's very important. Yeah, it's very, very important. So then faith cometh by hearing, and by hearing the word of the power Yahweh. You know, the elect, like Yahweh Shai said, my sheep hear my voice. You know, when the elect hear this word, right away they can take hold of it. You know, but the tutor of Israel, they despise it, and the heathen nations, them and the so-called white man, they despise this word. So, you know what I mean? Yeah. So we go back to Sirach. Yeah, Sirach 12. Salaki Sirach. Verse 12. He said, the fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of His love. And faith is the beginning to cleaving unto Him. You know what I mean? Yeah, so the fear is very, very important. Humbling yourself is very, very important. Yahweh Shai is very, very important. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 19, verse 18. Right? It says, the fear of the Lord Yahweh is the first step to be accepted Him. The fear of the Lord Yahweh is the first step to be accepted of Him, and wisdom obtaineth His love. So the fear again is very important, you know what I mean? To be accepted of the Most High Yahweh by Hashem, the fear, you know what I mean? Verse 19, he said, the knowledge of the commandments of the Lord Yahweh is the doctrine of life, and they that do things that please in Him, that please Him, shall receive the fruit of the tree, you know what I mean? And that's the fruit. The mortality, the tree of life, you know what I mean? That life is in His Son, Yahweh Shai, but you gotta believe on Him too, you know? That's very important too, you know? Verse 20, he said, the fear of the Lord Yahweh is wisdom. Fear of the Most High is all wisdom, you know? And in all wisdom is the performance of the law. And in all wisdom is the performance of the law. When you, as you said, practice a righteous act, you know what I mean? Yeah. And knowledge of His omnipotency, I mean, His almighty power. We know dread is the Heavenly Father. We know the Father could dash you in many pieces. You know, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai is a man of war. You know what I mean? This is why the elect gonna fear Him. You know, but two-thirds are not gonna fear Him. They mark for death. We know the end of them. You know, and the so-called white man and the other heathen nation, you know, so. Hope this was edifying to the elect out there, you know. And you know what I mean? So I want to give our praise to Hashem Yahweh Shai, double honors to our elders and our apostles who rule well at Great Millstone, you know, sanitation to all the Akims out there, you know, who pushing the gospel in sincerity and truth. You know what I mean? Shalom.